ولكن تحديت الظروف وخضتها وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أساهم حتى، وكم كرهت مصابها.
أيوب السختياني he's got profound statement. He said أهل البدع he said they all خوارج. أهل البدع all خوارج.
He
said يختلفون في الأسماء. They differ in their names. Some call themselves Deobandi, some Barelwi, some Sufi, some Ikhwani, some Shi'i, some...
Are you saying that all Barelwi, Sufis, Deobandi are all Khawarij?
I'm telling you what Ayyub Sakhtiani said.
So he named them by name.
Ayyub Sakhtiani, look at what he said. He said all of Ahl Bidah are Khawarij. That's his statement.
Okay.
Are they Ahl Bidah? Then according to his statement, not me. Blame him.
But you're applying the label Bidah onto them.
I'm just telling you what the Imam said.
Okay.
I'm telling you what the Imam said. I was told to follow.
Yeah.
Follow the immat of Salaf. Mm-hmm. That's what the Prophet
said. He left it general. He left it general.
Exactly.
You specified.
When you leave it general, then that's it. When you leave something general, it encompasses everything.
Okay.
So he said, Ahl Bidah are all Khawarij. يَخْتَلِفُونَ فِي الْأَسْمَى. They differ in their names. وَيَجْتَمِعُونَ. They all come together with the safe, the sword.
Radio Dawah Man quote Ayyub Sakhtiani, and he quoted the statement that all Ahl Bidah are Khawarij. And the example that he gave like, you know, the Deobandi, the Asha'ira, I think he said Ikhwan, I can't remember, Barelwis for some reason as well, even though, you know, I totally disagree with them. But they're not Khawarij. Let's just be fair and just. They're not Khawarij. And once again, heavily misapplied the statement. When he was pressed by the poor actor, Abu Bakr, he goes, look, what, you know, you call him. He goes, I'm just saying what the Imam has said. No context, no understanding of the reality of Al-Bid'ah that Ayyub Sakhtiani was referring to. And even then, when he quoted the author, he quoted it wrong as well, which makes it even worse. You know, if you're going to quote the author, quote it properly. You got all those paperwork there. Script writers, what are you doing, mate? Like, you know, at least give him the actual author properly, you know, if he's going to quote it. And on top of that, to extract such examples that, you know, are they, you know, Ash'aris, Deobandis, Barelwis, the Khawarij. And when he was pressed, he goes, I'm just saying what the Imam said. I was told to follow the Imam. Okay. So let's see what the statement actually says. Okay. Back to Shar al-Usul al-I'tiqad, okay, by Imam al-Lalika'i. Now I ask you a question. Why don't you ever have the books in front of you, mate? Why don't you have the books in front of you? All you've got is pieces of paper, okay, which is obviously given to you by the script writers that you must pay very well. And, you know, you're not even qualified to teach. Yet you don't have books in front of you. You know, I'll get the actual hard copy of the book and present it. I'm going to present it and I'll show you on screen. It shows, mate, you're just a muppet. You're just put there because, you know, you've got the channel base. All those payroll ustads that you pay, you know, do the job for you, write the script for you. And you're just there just uttering nothing but garbage. Okay? So as you can see on screen, okay, back to Shurul al-I'tiqad. Innal khawarij ikhtalafu fil ism. وَاجْتَمِعُوا عَلَى السَّيْفِ. That the Khawarij differ in their names. So it doesn't say يَخْتَلِفُونَ. It says اِخْتَلَفُوا. Okay, so again, you had the paper in front of you and you quoted it wrong. And then it says they unite upon the sword. Okay. So there's the statement from Ayyub al-Sakhtiani. Okay, that the Khawarij, that he used to call Khawarij, all of the Ahl al-Ahwa, all of them are Khawarij. And they differed in their names, but they're united upon the sword. And to present some historical context to this, that the Khawarij were notorious, and as their madhab and their usul, they used to make takfir and then do khuruj against the rulers. Mu'tazila were the same, and various other splinter groups from amongst them. That was their foundations to obviously cause civil discord and unite upon the sword. And they used to make takfir as well, like Ibn Taymiyyah said in Rad al-Bakri, when he talks about the Al-Bidah and he goes into them, they make takfir on those who oppose them. So when they made takfir, they used to unite, pick up the sword and rebel. Now to make a comparison, and again, I'm not Ash'ari and I'm not Deobandi and I'm not Barelwi and I'm not Ikhwani, but we have to have a certain amount of justice to those that we disagree with. And to label them as Khawarij, and then when pressed by the terrible actor, you're saying, I don't care. I'm just going what the Imam says. I'm just going what the Imam says. Like they're infallible or something. Do you know what I mean? So you see how they are very similar when it comes to how they view and they perceive and they follow and they take the statements of the Salaf like it's revelation. So your understanding of that statement, wallah al-azim, has serious implications and it is a dangerous, dangerous statement. Very dangerous. So I now look into the camera and speak to the Salafis. Again, the moderate Salafi brothers, they know Dawah Man is an absolute ignoramus. And someone from the Salafis, the moderate Salafis, even those obviously who are not followers of Dawah Man or SPOBs, need to come out. And honestly, I don't know how many times I've mentioned this or reiterated or called out for the elders, the public figures from amongst the Salafis to, you know, address this issue, because it's a serious issue. And when I do my videos or record my videos or highlight certain inconsistencies from amongst Salafis, I get noble Salafi brothers that contact me. I had some brother contact me today. And he goes, Hajji, I understand what you're doing. They do, you know, create such a negative image to the Salafi manhaj and Salafi da'wah and Salafi aqidah, these brothers, that they turn people away. And when I highlight this, it seems like I'm anti-Salafi, but I'm not. Because I want the Salafis to realize that, subhanAllah, you've got a major problem. You've got a major problem from amongst your circle, from amongst your movement. And yes, they may call themselves Salafis, but you've got to be vocal in opposing them. You have to be vocal in speaking out against them to separate yourself from them. They could call themselves Salafis all they want. They're not Salafis. So what I'm going to do now is present some statements from the Salaf. Okay? Let me see if you accept these. Okay? Because like I said, the Salaf were dealing with the notorious, deviated imposters, innovators of their time. And they had a certain amount of shiddah against them. You know? And bughdah. You know, hatred for them, which they should have, because they were innovating, you know, in the deen with major innovations, which was mukaffara. So let's sort of add some further statements from the Salaf and see if you apply this as well. Okay, back to Sharh al-Usul al-I'tiqad. Okay, let's go into it, because at the end of the day, look, we've got the book here. It's about time you do. Look at the bookmarks. Look, plenty, plenty, plenty to refute you on. Okay, as you can see on screen, this is number 255. And it mentions that Mu'ammal bin Ismail, if I said his name right, قال سمعت سفيان, this is Sufyan al-Thawri, يقول, Sufyan al-Thawri say, that the Muslims, all of them to us, are in a good state, in a good situation to us. Except two people, or two men. Who are they? صاحب البدعة, the innovator, and who else? Oh, Sahib al-Sultan, and the person who is of the ruler, or the person who is of the ruler. Now, there you go again. Sharh al-Usul al-I'tiqad, al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. So you want to take their statements as gospel. So if you have authority, and we got tyrant ruler was just ruler, to add further statements on top of this to show you that, you know, your manhaj of complete obedience to the ruler and you try to quote Salaf. No, I don't think so, son. When we present the statements of the Salaf, then I think you need to be the first to label them Khawarij because of their harsh stances against the rulers of their time. So you take the statements of the Salaf, like you said, I again we'll play it back.
But you're playing the label with that onto them.
I'm just telling you what the Imam said.
Okay.
I'm telling you what the Imam said. I was told to follow.
Yeah.
Follow the Immat of Salaf. Mm-hmm. That's what the Prophet
said. He left the general.
I'm just telling you what the Imam said. I was just told to follow. Taib, inshallah. No problem. So the Sahib al-Bid'ah, no problem. And Sahib al-Sultan. So the Salaf didn't have a good view about them. The person that's the Sahib al-Sultan. So now, I'm not going to mention any names. You were told to follow the Imam. Okay, you were told to follow. I've been told to follow the Imam of the Salaf. Okay? Okay? Sunnah! Okay? So you've been told to follow the Imams of the Salaf. Okay? That's what you've been told. Like, similar to the Rafidah. I've just been told to follow the Imams. Okay, no problem. So, Sufyan al-Thawri says that, you know, they've got no good opinions of those who visit the Sultan. Okay? So, what would you say about those who visit the Sultan then? So, it mentions 259. It states that Yahya bin Abi Kathir, قال إذا لقيت صاحب البدعة في الطريق. He said, if you meet a person of innovation on the road, then take another pathway. Okay? So take another pathway. So as you can see, 270, we've got a statement here from Al-Hasan, Al-Hasan al-Basri. قَالَ صَاحِبَ الْبِدْعَةِ لَا يُقْبِلُ اللَّهُ لَهُ صَلَاةً وَلَا صِيَامًا وَلَا حَجًّا وَلَا عُمْرَةً وَلَا جِهَادًا وَلَا صَرْفًا وَلَا عَدْلًا. Al-Hasan al-Basri says that the person of bid'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, won't accept his prayers, won't accept his fast, won't accept his hajj, won't accept his umrah, won't accept his jihad, etc., etc. And as you can see, 273, it mentions from another statement from the Imams of Salaf, it states that whoever reveres or adores a person of innovation, فَقَدْ عَانَ عَلَى حَدْمِ الْإِسْلَامِ, that he has contributed or aided in the destruction of Al-Islam. So now I ask you, with all of these statements that are presented, okay, with all of these statements that are presented, does this also apply to the Ikhwanis? Does this also apply to the Ash'ari? Does this also apply to the Deobandi? Does this also apply to all, even the Barelwis, just add them in there as well? Does it apply to all of them? So Allah won't accept any of our prayers. Allah won't accept any of our hajjs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't accept any of our umrahs, etc.
وكم كرهت مصابها لكن رأيت الخير يسكب في أنا كم مرة قد ضقت من عظم البلاء بشر وشيطان يحاصرني أبا كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب ضحى وتحدر الدمع وضاقت بي رؤى كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي كم مرة قد ضاق قلبي من أساه محنته وكم كرهت